John, how are you?
Hanging in there, man. It's... We're hanging in there, really. Recital prep is really the name of the game right now, I guess. The piece is really coming along. In the third act, I'm trying to get really edgy with, like, how fast I can go in the third act. I don't want it to be dangerous, because it could slip and fall, and we don't want that to happen, but I'm trying to get it as fast as possible. I played it for Lee. He really liked it. He thought the third act was actually the highlight of the piece, but I think we talked about, I was a little on the fence about whether or not I wanted to wear shoes for that section, and he says I should because they're squeaky, and the squeaking is like a funny sound. He likes that. So...
Yeah, I think you probably should wear, I know the logistics would be a little tough on that, but you should wear shoes for that, I think.
I can make time in the fourth act to put the shoes back on so that all the visuals are going to match up with shoes and non-shoes.
What is your general opinion of the piece? Like, have you enjoyed practicing it? I know that this is, like, a little crazy.
It's a little crazy, but I really have enjoyed it. You know, the thing about this piece you've written is that it doesn't get practiced in the normal way. I have to, like, really explore the reaches of improvisation with it, but it doesn't demand the kind of shedding that, like, some other things do. It's more like, when I practice, I'm just trying to push the boundaries outwards. And also, I really like how you only complimented yourself once. That's good for you.
Yeah, by the end of the piece, you might want to punch me.
That doesn't seem likely. What is it that you're going to make me do? What do you think about the clothes for the piece? I'm thinking about wearing this shirt for the recital. It's got, it kind of looks like it's not showing up on the camera, but it's got stripes. It looks like they're messing with the video. Are you seeing that on your end?
Yeah. At least you're wearing pants. Is the end of the piece okay? You messaged me about how vulnerable Act 4 is, but I'm more interested in if you think the epilogue works.
Well, it was fun to record, for sure, you know? Very funny, but I'm still not sure on, like, the going into the drum.
Trust me, it'll work out fine. Once it's open, we can go home.
Go home?
Yeah, you know, we'll be done.
Sure. Okay.
Thank you.
the ending for this is tough. I'm way behind on everything right now. I'm so sorry. I've had to ask, like, to not do a bunch of stuff. You'll probably want to punch me by the end of this piece.
It's okay, Tucker. I'm not going to want to punch you. I don't know why you keep bringing this up. It's not going to happen. I promise you. It helps with this piece, you know? It's not the most time-consuming thing to learn, you know? It's okay. It's really going to be fine. I promise.
I'm going to make it out. All right, I'll still try to get it to you on time. I feel really bad about how long this is taking.
It's okay. I mean, mostly I've been messing around with, like, the stuff you've already told me with the actual improvisations, trying to get some interesting sounds out of Bryce. it's coming along. It's going to be fine.
Yeah, I'm really excited about the way that the snare drum changes identity during the piece and sort of is a rice cooker and is all these different things.
Yeah, my internet connection's unstable. I think I missed what you just said there.
Oh, I was just talking about the snare drum's identity.
Yeah, it's like, what I like about what we're doing here is that it feels less like a composition for snare drum and more like a piece of theater that centers around the snare drum. Yeah, like as more of like a prop than an instrument. It's like Chekhov's snare drum. You know, a snare drum introduced in the first act goes on fire by the third act. Is that how it goes?
Yeah, it's something like that.
Like that, right?
That's kind of the idea of the piece for sure.
Yeah, okay, so how's this ending going to work? You sent me that video of the skit that your friend did, right?
Is
it just going to cut to that? Like, how's that going to happen?
That's actually what I really wanted to talk about. How do you think we should end? I'm thinking about the space metaphor having you somehow like land on the drum or go into the drum.
Okay, so hear me out here. I actually have an idea about this. So I have this like old concert bass drum here in school. I could make a paper head for it, like a paper head that I can break myself, and we can make it up so it looks like a giant snare drum. And then I can just bust the head open with my fists and climb inside the drum. Like, what do you think about it? The only downside is that it's gonna be like I'm a tiny little person getting inside a regular sized drum. But I mean, what do you think? What do you think about that?
I suppose there is like a little people thing there somewhere, but. I feel like it's a little violent for the context of, like, this piece. What do you think about, like, entering the drum somehow, but, like, using the snare, like, normal size snare drum?
Metaphorically entering? You gotta understand, I'm pretty big. I can't get inside the drum. It's not, like, maybe you could, but I can't. It's not big enough. Tell me why we need to go inside the drum.
I don't know. I feel like the drum, maybe it's the world. Maybe it's like communication, the space between these two like resonating heads.
Space between two heads. It's a little on the nose, but it's true. That is true. What if I just walk off stage, just really abruptly?
I mean, you could try it.
Like this, just.
Ah, dude, you aren't wearing pants?
Can you see me?
Of course I can see you. I plan to be at the concert, or at least watching the live stream. We would have to work something out about the passion, but even if I can't be there, that would really suck.
But we were on Zoom.
Well, this is no way to end the piece. I'm really into this entering the drum thing. I will figure it out. Please wear pants to our next Zoom call. thanks again so much for asking to write this piece for you. I'm really excited about putting it together. I know your recital is focused on text and electronics with snare drum. Pieces like the Akiho deal with this fragmentation and abstraction of texts. And other works have this more like narrative style. I'm thinking about a piece that's made up entirely of text, like notation, concept, and then everything. What I've sent you so far is text instructions about that idea with the snare drum as the rice cooker.
Yeah, what I've seen so far, I really like it. I don't really have a feel totally for like the format of the recital, but what I'm sort of thinking is that it'll be like a survey of all the different ways that text can be used as a basis for music, specifically in the case of like snare drum music. And that this is like kind of the most out there interpretation of it, because it's like derived from text, but it's pretty esoteric, you know?
I'm thinking about incorporating video too,
Yeah. Like
not just electronics, which might be kind of complex to set up. Do you think you'll have access to a projector for that?
Yeah, we'll have a projector, and I can run anything on my laptop and project it behind me.
Great. What do you think about this whole text thing? I mean, you said it earlier, but the snare drum. Really, what do you think of the snare drum becoming these like different sort of surfaces or objects you interact with? This like membrane through which you interact with the world.
I love it. It's like it really makes me think about like the idea that because of the quarantine, like all the ways we interact with the world are through screens, and like you can think of the head as being like a kind of screen, like not the kind of screen that people mean when they talk about screen time, but it's sort of like it, I guess, right? It's got like the whole thing has like an absurdist, surrealist feel to it. That's what you mean, right?
Yeah, right now the material is really just these little vignettes, but there would be some kind of like semantic or like guide or like a dialogue of sorts to guide us through this piece, sort of grounding conceptually. I think, sort of thinking about that, the snare drum is sort of like this door in Monsters, Inc., where it's like this surface or threshold. I'm thinking you could even zoom me through the piece.
Like literally or metaphorically? Because I can see either way working. Like it's like the snare drum is a screen, and like it represents a screen, and you could like metaphorically represent like me looking into my laptop screen to zoom. And we could like, I mean, do you think we could just do the zoom live? Like,
I don't know. I mean, it would depend on like if we can keep this stable connection.
There's a lot that could go wrong.
Yeah, I think it might be best to record them. We'll see. Did you read the pants thing? I'm also thinking about having you like eat rice at some point towards the end of the piece. Like the rice that you were making at the very beginning of the piece is done cooking, and now you get to enjoy it.
Yeah, no, the pants thing is fine. Like, it's just pants, right? I can't let it. It's just pants.
Yeah,
we're good.
And I want to work. Maybe like your voice into it. I know that you do some work with guitar and singing. We've worked together on that before. I'll try to get the piece to you in October at some time. But I think I'm gonna have you sing